In this video, I will explain about insect digestive system. Insect digestive system is differentiated into three parts: foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Foregut is also called as stomodium, midgut is mesenteron, and hindgut is proctodium. Foregut and hindgut are ectodermal in origin, while midgut is endodermal in origin. Alimentary canal or digestive system is longer in phytophagous insects compared to carnivorous and other insects like detritivorous insects. So alimentary canal is longer in phytophagous insects. These are all the salivary glands, these are all the mouth parts. So if you look at the digestive system parts, the first part is pharynx, which involved in ingestion and passage of food particles to the esophagus. Whereas esophagus, it is a tube like structure, so which receives the food from pharynx and pass it on to the crop. This one is a crop which acts as temporary storage of food. In some insects, this crop is modified into lateral diverticulum, especially in Lepidoptera and Diptera. Next one is proventriculus. It is also called as gizzards or denticles. So this proventriculus helps in mastication of food particles in solid feeding insects. At the junction of foregut and midgut, there is a valve present called as stomodial valve, which prevents the regurgitation of food particles, that is, which prevents the backflow of food. These are all the finger-like structure present in the midgut called as gastric cecae or ventric cecae. It increases the surface area for digestion and absorption of food particles, because most of the digestion and absorption of the food particles takes place in the anterior part of the midgut. And this one is peritropic membrane. Peritropic membrane plays an important role in insect digestive system because it protects the epithelial layer. This epithelial layer consists of cells which are involved in secretion of digestive enzymes and also absorption of food particles. This peritropic membrane is present in solid feeding insects but absent in liquid feeder. Especially in solid feeding insects, it is absent in ants, but usually absent in solid feeding, liquid feeding insects, that is shaft feeders. But even in shaft feeders also, it is present in bearded butterfly, that is bearded butterfly adult. But in other insects like in hemipterans, dipterans, and lepidopterans, which feeds on sap, it is this peritropic membrane is absent. And next one, it is a tubular part of the midgut, is called ventriculus. At the junction of midgut and hindgut, you may find the valve called as pyloric valve, which regulates the food flow. And if you look at the hindgut, these are all long finger-like structures called as malpighian tubules. These malpighian tubules regulates the salt, water, and nitrogenous waste excretion. Hindgut is differentiated into three parts: ileum, colon, and rectum. Ileum, it is the anterior part of the hindgut, which is pouch-like and harbors the symbionts. That is, expansion of ileum is called the paunch in termites, and in larval scarabids, this is called as the fermentation chamber. And next one is colon. So this one, it is present between ileum and rectum. It is just like a tubular part. And last one is rectum, posterior part of the hindgut, which helps in reabsorption of water, ions, and other minerals from the urine. So if you look at the function of the whole digestive system, the first one is foregut. It involved in ingestion of the food particles, passage of food to the midgut, temporary storage of food, and the partial digestion of food takes place in the foregut. Because of the salivary gland secretion, saliva containing digestive enzymes which helps in partial digestion of the food in the foregut itself, and it prevents the regurgitation of the food because of stomatal valve. And if you look at the midgut, it increases the surface area for digestion and absorption of the food particles, and it absorbs other minerals, water, amino acids, etc., and secretion of the digestive enzymes. And if you look at the hindgut, reabsorption of water, minerals, vitamins, amino acids takes place, excretion of waste food material. In some insects like in termites, that digestion of cellulose occur in paunch, and it acts as housing for symbionts, especially in even in scarabids, larval scarabids, that is fermentation chamber. So this is about digestive system structure. And next one is salivary glands. It is also called as labial glands because in some insects labial glands are modified salivary glands. A pair of salivary glands present in insects. The ducts from each gland usually joins to form a single common duct that opens just below the hypopharynx. There are two types of salivary glands present in insects. One is acinous gland. Acinous salivary gland, it has a reservoir like this, and it is present in most of the insects. Whereas tubular salivary glands, it has no reservoirs, mainly present in Lepidoptera, Diptera and Siphonoptera. If you look at the functions performed by the salivary glands, the saliva which containing some digestive enzymes involved in digestion of the particular compound, like amylase for the digestion of the starch, invertase for digestion of sucrose. In gastritids, saliva contains lipases and protease enzyme for lipids and protein digestion. It also contains toxins which produces necrotic tissue. In plant work, saliva contains pectinase which helps in stylet penetration, as well as in some bugs which helps in extra intestinal digestion. Mosquito saliva containing two compounds like anticoagulin which prevents the clotting of blood, and it also containing an anesthetic compound which makes the victim to the unaware of its bite. And gallmate saliva contains indole acetic acid which produces galls on plant parts. And in some insects like in Trichoptera and silkworms, it helps in production of silk. Next one is enzymes involved in digestion. That is, first one is carbohydrate digestion. These are all the enzymes involved in carbohydrate digestion. Amylases, which acts on 1,4 alpha glycosidic linkages. There are two types of amylases involved, exoamylases and endoamylases, which acts on terminal site as well as internal bond of glycosidic linkages respectively. Whereas the disaccharides and other trisaccharides or polysaccharides are broken down into monosaccharides for absorption. So these are all the enzymes involved in the digestion, like alpha glucosidases, beta glucosidases, alpha galactosidases, beta galactosidases, beta fructase. So these enzymes involved in the hydrolysis of these different particular compounds. And next one is cellulase enzyme involved in the digestion of cellulose, whereas lichinases acts on lichenin, pectinases acts on pectin, invertases acts on sucrose. Next one is enzymes involved in protein digestion. There are three types of enzymes involved. First one is endopeptidases. So these endopeptidases includes serine proteases, which acts on trypsin and chemotrypsin, whereas thiol proteases, which acts on cysteine. Second one is exopeptidases, which includes carboxypeptidases and aminopeptidases. And the third one is that keratin. That keratin is enzyme which acts on keratin to break down the disulfide bond, which is present in wool, hair and feather. The keratin is a feather protein. Next one is lipids, lipid digestion. Lipids are the esters of fatty acids and glycerol. That enzymes acts on the lipids to convert into mono and diacyl glycerols for the absorption. Lipases, which acts on long chain fatty acids. Esterases acts on short chain fatty acids, whereas phosphatases, which acts on phospholipids. Several enzymes involved in the enzyme secretion, that is digestive enzyme secretion. So among them, few are columnar cells or principal cells. These cells are mainly involved in digestive enzyme secretion. Second one is goblet cells. These cells involved in maintaining the midgut ionic balance, especially present in larval lepidopterans. And the regenerative cells involved in regeneration of columnar cells. Next one is filter chamber. So this filter chamber is present mainly in phloem feeding insects like homopterans. In many homopteran insects which feeds on low concentrated plant sap, so it ingests large volume of plant sap to fulfill its nutrient requirement. As a result, the modification of this gut provide rapid elimination of excess water present in the plant sap so that it gets the required amount of concentrated nutrients. So these are all the parts involved in the filter chamber formation. That is, filter chamber is formed by the two extremities end of midgut, that is anterior end of midgut as well as posterior end of midgut, and anterior end of hindgut with the proximal part of Malpighian tubules, which forms the filter chamber. You can see here anterior end of the midgut, and this one is posterior end of the midgut, and the anterior end of the hindgut, proximal part of the Malpighian tubules, so which forms the filter chamber. This allows rapid elimination of excess water present in the plant sap directly from the anterior midgut, so that it can eliminate the excess water. The midgut is differentiated into three parts. Anterior midgut is called ventriculus 1, whereas middle part of the midgut is called as ventriculus 2, and posterior part of the midgut is ventriculus 3. This ventriculus 1 and ventriculus 3, which forms the filter chamber, whereas the concentrated nutrients, after eliminating the water, the concentrated nutrients pass into the ventriculus 2, where digestion and absorption of food particles takes place. The main function of filter chamber is to remove the water directly from the anterior part of the midgut, and it increases the intake of plant sap to fulfill the nutrient requirement, and it also avoids the hemolymph dilution. And next one is extra-intestinal digestion. This extra-intestinal digestion is also called as extra-oral digestion. That means digestion of the food particles takes place outside the body by regurgitation of some enzymes into the food before ingestion. So in some insects, that mouth parts are modified in such a way that they cannot take the food directly. So insect ingests saliva into the food prior to the ingestion. This saliva containing some digestive enzymes, which constitutes the major part of the total digestion in some insects. Like this type of extraoral digestion you can see in adult Cialidae and Empidae belongs to the order Diptera, larval Neuroptera, Dytiscus and Lamparides belongs to the order Coleoptera, Heliconin butterflies which inject the saliva into the pollen and liquefy the pollen so that it can feed easily on the pollens. And Dytiscus, Dysdyrcus, whereas Oncopeltis species which feeds on seeds. So in this box also you can see the extraoral digestion. So that's it about insect digestive system. If you have any doubts, please comment below the video. Thank you.